describe something as epic is to say that it is heroic, on a grand scale, impressively great, recalling the act or behavior of a deity. So like a lot of words these days, it is overused to the point of having diminished its meaning.
I got to thinking about this while playing around with the slow motion capabilities of my GoPro Hero 6. I do a lot of action photography here on the beach. I like to photograph the kite surfers and dogs chasing tennis balls. And I sometimes put those photographs into videos, and adding slow motion just seemed like an obvious extension of the action photography.
You know, the wind shifted from southwest to northwest, so it's not as nice as it was an hour ago, but I'm here, so I'm gonna go. It's gonna be a little choppy. We were hoping it would stay southwest and be smooth, but it's windy. That's the good thing.
But a slow motion video clip can be boring, and so you have to add dramatic or cinematic music to make it more interesting. But this kind of music combined with slow motion conveys the sense that the video is intended to be epic. And this can come off as being overstated or cheesy.
I'm getting set up to photograph Ben surfing.
Northwest, which I like a lot. I like the direction a lot. But it's very up and down, like pretty much every 10 minutes. It's very, it goes down and then comes back up. But it was a lot of fun. A little holy. It's gonna be southwest tomorrow, a little friendlier. But I like this direction for jumping and stuff, or trying to jump, so that's kind of where I'm at. All in all, it was just good to get on the water, you know? I can't speak too clearly right now because I'm cold as shit.
When I'm photographing the surfers in the winter, I'm standing on the beach and the temperatures are in the 30s or the 40s and it's windy. My hands are so painful and so cold that I can barely press the shutter button on my camera. And I have immense admiration for the surfers, but I can't help but think that they must be miserable, because I'm miserable and I'm standing on the beach while they're out in the water. What motivates them to do this?
It scares you a little bit, you know, because you just go through life, you live your life, you've got your job, you've got, you know, your family, everything. You try to make it as productive and as rewarding as you can. But every once in a while, you want to scare yourself. And I try to do that once in a while. And this can be very scary at times, because when the wind picks up and it's blowing 30, 40, mile an hour, you're out there and you're right on the edge, and that's thrilling. It's such a rush, and that's part of making life a little more than the mundane, than the everyday going through life and doing your, you know, whatever you do. This is something that just gives you that spike.
Thames remarks that surfing is a way of escaping a mundane world. I think must be central to the motivation behind what they do. They are leaving behind a world of rigid cultural expectations and banality, and they are entering a world of an unpredictable nature of wind and water. And I think they must find that this challenges their courage and their endurance. And in this, they find something that is lacking in our everyday lives. It's like they're walking out to the ocean and facing it and saying, "Game on." So is kite surfing epic? You decide.